TaylorMade have got some new golf balls on the market. I'm going to review the Tour Response stripe. As you can see, there is a stripe on the golf ball. Now there is a soft response and Tour Response. So for Tour Response, it's all the same material. It's just this difference in color. So you've got the pure white ball, a yellow ball, and the stripe ball, which is going to help with alignment. I'm here at Reddish Vale. I'm going to try out this alignment aid and tell you what I think about it. Before we get into this video, please can you like and subscribe to our channel so you don't miss out on any of our new content. When I took these balls out of the packet, I thought they'll be ideal for putting. But having teed it up, I can use it on my tee shots as well. So whenever you have the ball in your hand, you can use the alignment aid. You can see there, this is going down the middle of the fairway. I always stand behind the ball, align the ball up to something in the distance, which is the highest tree. I've always done that. I've always used whatever alignment aid, be it how small it is, I've always used that. Gives you great security on your tee shots that you're aiming the club and the ball in the right place. So thumbs up for tee shots. It does look a bit weird. I can see a lot of white golf ball this side, and then the other side, it's a lime, that lime green, which clashes with the grass. It does make the ball, it doesn't make the ball look round though, because of the difference in the colour on the golf ball. What I'm going to do is I'm going to play a few holes and try and get my head around it, because it could just be something that right now I think, oh, I don't like the look of that, and then you can just get over it. I did it with the TaylorMade picks. I really like that now. So let's bear with it. This is a three-layer golf ball. It's got a new seamless tour flight dimple pattern, so the dimple pattern's changed to help it fly better through the air. It's a higher launching ball, a high spin ball, and it's gonna feel soft. I'm gonna head inside and have a quick look at the numbers, but outside, I'm enjoying the performance. Head-to-head challenge, a few scenarios, taking the stripe against the plain ball. Now I'm not even going to use that slight line on the ball, I'm just going to put it down plain. So it's kind of all versus nothing.
My verdict on the TaylorMade Tour Response stripe. On playing golf, at the tee and at the green, really good. An advantage. I align my ball up a lot better. The in-between can get a bit annoying. You can lose your ball because of the lime green in the rough. And obviously, if it's not at the perfect line, that might be off-putting. Okay, so you're going to gain, I think, a lot at the beginning and at the end of the hole. And you've got to work out what would you rather give away. Do the pros outweigh the cons? In terms of indoor testing, it was slightly lower spinning than the TP5X, but it did launch higher. Outdoor, it's a bit cold. Barely notice any difference, in fairness. The testing of the putting. This is where you're going to really see the benefits of this golf ball. If you are somebody that struggles to line your ball up and hit it in the spot that you want to do, there's three keys to putting well. You need to read the green, you need to hit the ball where you want to hit it, and you need to get the right speed. This stripe sorts out that second one a lot better. Obviously, you need to be able to line the stripe up in the correct position, so you'd need to practice that. It could slow you down. We've seen it on the television with tour pros. If it's not quite right, they go back to the ball again. Maybe because it's a bit thicker, you won't have that, but it could slow you down. The positives is that it did help with my putting. When I had a clear white ball, I over hit putts, as in I started the ball on the wrong line, either too high, in fact too high, on left to right and right to left putts. I overdo things. I would rather miss on the pros side, which is a load of rubbish because it just misses anyway. With this line, I thought, no, commit to that. You've lined it up correctly and put through it. I had to worry a lot less about start line and more about the read and the pace. It won the test against a totally blank ball. So yes, it will help with your putting and your alignment, but can you get over the funkiness of this golf ball? That's up to you. Do the pros outweigh the cons? They did for me. Price-wise, these balls are coming in at £39.99, which is £10 less than the TP5 range. That's because it is that three-layer golf ball. It's still a very good golf ball. If you don't like the stripes, you can go for the yellow ball, which apparently sits up more and flies better visually through the air, and obviously the plain white ball. But if you struggle with hitting your putts where you want to hit them, then why not give this ball a go? Please like, comment and subscribe. Comment, would you use a training aid, which I think this used to be on the golf course? Would you be happy doing that? If you want to read the written review, check it out on golfalot.com. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you again soon.